Welcome to another inking session. Today I just got a kind of a simple character design, more abstract Picasso type, getting the court jester feel for some reason, but yeah, and I just wanted to get this thing inked now that I look at it a moment. Had that go underneath it. Last minute spec designs or something. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, just gonna jump right into it. Again, this is just really abstract, just kinda, when I drew it, it was like a real free-formed type, not thinking about anything, just making some lines and see what happened, which was the initial head part, and kinda liked it, so I kinda saw the character there, so I just kinda drew out the body normally. And just went with it. I kind of liked it, so. Just kind of making up that interior face detail as I go. Nothing really set in my pencils because I'm making it. I don't really have it all that detailed out. I just kind of think about what I want it to be. So far, so good. move into some markers to get the kind of solidify all my lines. I could do a 03. Whole inking process went pretty smooth. Again, just coming in here and kind of thickening up the lines. And I'm gonna box it in to give it a little portrait status, even though I'll probably erase this digitally and for the digital version of this, I'll probably just put one in Photoshop. Using an 05, pretty thick one. pretty happy with that one. Give it a little air dry real quick. So I'm gonna come in and clean it up eraser wise. Before we make some hard decisions with the Copic markers, because I think my last one, I just thought some of the colors were too dark, and I think I felt like I messed it up. But I can always redraw it, so it's never the end of the world. But yeah. Definitely work light. Starting with the C1 with the Copic markers. I don't know if you can see that or not, but it will. That's what it is. So coming here and working in the shadow lines, whatever they may be. Kind of see this. Top half is like some type of bone structure, if that makes sense to you. Definitely wanted it curved, less defined. It's kind of already not making sense, but I like it. I'm glad I caught that. Whew. I almost want to say go dark on the legs. Maybe give a C3 on the whatever you call that. What do you call that? Poncho type thing, I guess. I don't know. Running out of C3, I gotta refill it. So anyway, pull out the lid thing. I'm gonna do this away from the part and just barely squeeze. And you can see it fill in the chamber up. Got the air bubble there. But again, never put a lot because it will bleed out. Slosh around a little bit. Check it on another piece of paper. Just make sure it's not bleeding the hell out of it. Right. Now back to the jam. Got a bleeder. That's something we can fix. I'm not too worried about it. coming in C5 for the dark parts. To refill this C5 as well. Again, don't fill it up. Just put a little bit in there to keep it going. because it will bleed out all over your artwork. Found that out the hard way. Alright, I think I'm done with that. Maybe do a few little highlights to make some things pop, especially up in here. happy with the way that turned out. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to post them in the comments or email me if you want to watch a faster version of this. I'll post a time lapse on my Instagram, just at @_Vasic, V-A-S-I-C. I post a lot of time lapse there, and then the long form videos here on YouTube.